it's time to bring on your questions for Pat. And Pat, yeah. This first one is from Carolyn, who says, why are there people who say they died, went to heaven, and then came back? Does this mean they won't ever die again, or does it simply mean they weren't really dead when they saw heaven?
No, they were dead, but so what's called a resuscitation, there is a resurrection. The time will come when we are given new bodies, spiritual bodies, the same kind that Jesus had when he rose from the dead. That's the resurrection. These are resuscitations. The people die, but they are resuscitated. Just like Lazarus, he was dead so much so that his corpse was stinking, but yet Jesus brought him back. And his spirit went back into his body. But yes, he would die again. Because that is a resuscitation, not resurrection. Right?
Here's a really good question. This is from Brendan, who says, I have a fear of death. How can I stop being afraid of dying?
Well, you can read the Bible. You can get close to the Lord. You can listen to some of these testimonies we're having now. Listen, you know, the Bible says that those who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage. The fear of death is Satan's way of keeping us in bondage. But we need to have our conscience cleared that we would understand that you don't have to be afraid of death. Jesus Christ broke the penalty of death. And you read what the Apostle Paul has to say in 1 Corinthians, oh, death, where is thy sting? There is no sting any longer in death because Jesus Christ has broken the bonds of death. And he's opened the way into heaven for us, so we don't have to fear any longer. You just have to read the Bible. You have to focus on the Lord, and you begin to praise him for it. And you know, you're afraid because you're thinking about you. You start thinking about Jesus, and it'll change your perspective. All right?
This is Alana, who says, how can heaven be perfect if all of our loved ones aren't there?
Well, it's going to be perfect for those that are there. You will, I think, be so absorbed in the presence of God, so filled with his awe and wonder and majesty and the joy that's there, that there'll be no sorrow, no tears, no crying. So you won't be crying over loved ones. So it's perfect, but...
And many people who've gone and had that death experience have talked about that perfect love being so... overwhelming, so overpowering, right. That nothing existed
but
that.
The reality is that, and that absorbs everything else. All right.
This is Phil, who says, can people in heaven look down and see those of us who are still on earth?
I don't think so. I don't think we want a bunch of dead people looking in on everything we're doing. I think, you know, it really isn't.
What do you think of the scripture that says that there's a cloud of witnesses? What do you think that means?
Well, the cloud of witnesses are those who've gone before us, who witnessed to the faith of the Lord.
Not necessarily witnessing our race.
That's right. We're surrounded by those who have testified for the faith of God. I think that's it. They're the witnesses who surround us, those of history.
Okay, this is Mark, who says, what will we look like in heaven?
Well, I think we're going to be like the angels, but I also think that when we have a resurrection body, it will be a perfection of where we are. But, you know, the Apostle Paul said it's like a seed falls in the ground, like wheat. You see a little kernel, and then all of a sudden comes up this glorious stalk. And so he said that's what it's going to be like when we're in the resurrection. All right.
Well, that's all the time we have for questions today. Boy, we've had some interesting questions this week as we focused on heaven and hell. We hope everything that you've seen and heard drives you to passionately find out more about Jesus Christ and who he is.
Well, Monday, a college freshman gone wild gets a second chance. And today we leave you with these words from Malachi. To you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings. We'll see you on Monday. Until then, God bless you. Goodbye.